for Timbo.
Thank you.
You're just gonna kill the clock.
Oh,
White Orange carry. Second by 55, Brent Powell of Greenwood. Third down and three.
Oh, yeah, I got him blocked. I just put it on.
Ball at the 7 yard line.
I didn't know where Michael was.
Yeah. to take some time out and recognize the efforts that those students put into this year along with their parents. Each game was a little better, and they capped it off grandly down to state championships. Good job. And now we'd like to introduce individually the members of the Marceline Tigers, our state champions. Number 13, Chester Solario. Thank you. Tim Tucker. generally filled the halls of the school with a lot of spirit and a lot of pep. They were responsible for and organized each pep assembly. They put the spirit back in our school spirit. May I present our varsity cheerleader.
Dedication, and purpose. You have made us all proud to wear the black and gold. Looking back on this season, the state championship was truly a team effort. Who would have thought that in a community of 3,000 people, we had 2,500 screaming fans down in Arrowhead. You were all part of the team, not only in Arrowhead, but all season long. Other team members that deserve major recognition are first the cheerleaders. What an outstanding year that they had. As far as our school spirit went. Also, congratulations are in order for our band. Not only did they support throughout the season, but also the postseason. We had beautiful weather, and I think that on Friday evening, they sounded better down there on Arrowhead than they did all season long. Congratulations. And congratulations are also in order to the student body. The student body who supported the team all year long. Again, my congratulations to all. I'm very proud to be your superintendent. You made us all proud. This entire season and the state championship, we were nothing less than a first-class act. Thanks, guys.
President of the Board of Education, Mr. Joe Cox.
Well, I'd like to add to this group my congratulations. You know, I was trying to think of something appropriate to say and what it takes to win a state championship. Obviously, I don't know. We never won one, so Scott clues in on that. One thing that I was able to do as an old Marshalling football player, something that you guys probably will never be able to do. I know that some of the guys I played with that could make it up in their living room chairs today, like Wayne Darling, Bill Toops, Joe Martinez, and Dwight Yates. We at least got to lie about our accomplishments. We got better as the years went by. I'm afraid lying wouldn't improve on the performance of this team. If you were to look at Arrowhead Stadium last Friday night, you would have thought that the Marsh team was four times the size of Springfield, Missouri. And although we all know that that's not the case, I think it was very evident that the Marsh team fans do have four times the desire, the support, and the commitment of not only Springfield, but probably any other community this size in the United States. I think it's an indication to you as athletes as to how much this community appreciates your efforts and how much they also appreciate the tradition that we have come to know as Marshalling Tiger football. Now, believe it or not, when you gentlemen were born, the doctor said, it's a boy, not it's a linebacker. Even though some of the fathers up there might have said some things like that. But no woman ever gave birth to a 7-pound, 6-ounce strong safety. So how did you get to become football players? Well, I think we all know that starting about the 15th of August, you just work your tail off, and the end of November, and there's other sports that you participate in. Weight training during the summer is a big commitment. But I think one intangible that's possibly overlooked a lot is the contribution, the care, the support, and the love that you get from your family members. I'd like the family of these athletes to please stand up. Traveling around on school board activities, you generally get a badge. Mine says Joe Cut, Marshalling, Missouri, and everybody says, Marshalling, oh, you guys got a great football program. You got tough kids. But what that is tradition, gentlemen, and that tradition started many years ago. I like to refer to it in the years B.C. That stands before Cotton. Tradition is walking off the football field after you've just beaten someone 70-0 in Cotton Sand. If you'd have cried a little harder, you could have done better. It's also the referee walking off the football field and Doris Holt saying, if you'd have cried a little harder, you could have done better. Not only taken care of it, but you've given it its finest hour. We all think. One last thing I would like to say is that success is a journey, it's not a destination. So you have to move on from here. So where do you go? I do know that this year's 2A champion is a town called Louisiana, Missouri. And I think I know a team who beat those folks a couple years ago.
Accomplishments accomplishments of this senior class. And I think most people in Lawrence Lane knows by now the four LCC conference championships, the bells, and what a sweet topping with a state championship. It's just too bad we don't have more seniors that have gone through the years with this group. And another good thing about it is I hope that this state championship will be a springboard to maybe the young kids that are sitting out there in the audience, the junior high players and all. If you're going to keep that tradition going, we need you. The program needs you. And it's important that we have you. So I think we're all going to miss the five seniors. They've been tremendous this year as far as the leadership. And again, I'd like to have them come up in front of the group. I would like to shake their hand in public and officially say goodbye to them. Boys. Football team and the captains, we'd like to present the class 1A state championship trophy to a principal to put it in the trophy case. Finish the ball, Mr. Reese. This is the official autographed ball that the championship teams receive. We will have this autographed, and it will also remain in the trophy case.
Proud of what we do, and we want to just keep
getting better. I mentioned to our students when we first had the chance to meet them at the beginning of the year, we're not content just to be good. We want to be the best, and we are. Thank you all.
Thank you. Don't get Michelle on the phone.
Go, Michael!
Number 12, Paul.
Number 28 by 4 on the mid-30 for Mark.
on the 17-yard line.
Thank you.
and considering that the amount of people we had down in Kansas City, you were able to see what I thought anyway was probably the best performance of the season. And although we don't have an awful lot of them here today, I would still like to take some time out and recognize the efforts that those students put into this year along with their parents. Each game was a little better, and they capped it off grandly down to state championships. Good job. And now we'd like to introduce individually the members of the Marceline Tigers, our state champions. Number 13, Chester Solario. Richard Warner. them dance. Julie Wright. Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Scott Tavola.
I'd like to offer my congratulations to Coach Bill Dennis and the coaching staff, to the players, and to everyone else that was involved in this state championship season. To win a state championship takes pride, dedication, and purpose. You have made us all proud to wear the black and gold. Looking back on this season, the state championship was truly a team effort. Who would have thought that in a community of 3,000 people, we had 2,500 screaming fans down in Arrowhead? You were all part of the team, not only in Arrowhead, but all season long. Other team members that deserve major recognition: our first, the cheerleaders. What an outstanding year that they had as far as our school spirit went. Also, congratulations are in order for our band. Not only did they support throughout the season, but also the postseason, we had beautiful weather, and I think that on Friday evening, they sounded better down there in Arrowhead than they did all season long. Congratulations. And congratulations are also in order to the student body. The student body who supported the team all year long. Again, my congratulations to all. I'm very proud to be your superintendent. You've made us all proud. This entire season and the state championship, we were nothing less than a first-class act. Thanks, Matt.
Joe Cobb.
congratulations, and I was trying to think of something appropriate to say and what it takes to win a state championship. Obviously, I don't know. We never won one, so Scott clues in on that. One thing that I was able to do as an old Marshalling football player is something that you guys probably will never be able to do. I know that some of the guys I played with that could make it up in their living room chairs today, like Wayne Darrell, Bill Toops, Joe Martinez, and Dwight Yates. We at least got to lie about our accomplishments. We got better as the years went by. I'm afraid lying wouldn't improve on the performance of this team. If you were to look at Arrowhead Stadium last Friday night, you would have thought that Marshalling was four times the size of Springfield, Missouri. And although we all know that that's not the case, I think it's very evident that the Marshalling fans do have four times the desire, support, and the commitment of not only Springfield, but probably any other community this size in the United States. I think it's an indication to you as athletes as to how much this community appreciates your efforts and how much they also appreciate the tradition that we have come to know as Marshalling Tiger football. Now, believe it or not, when you gentlemen were born, the doctor said, it's a boy, not it's a linebacker. Even though some of the fathers up there might have said some things like that. But no woman ever gave birth to a 7-pound, 6-ounce strong safety. So how did you get to become football players? Well, I think we all know that starting about the 15th of August, you just work your tail off. And the end of November, and there's other sports that you participate in. Weight training during the summer is a big commitment. But I think one intangible that's possibly overlooked a lot is the contribution, the care, the support, and the love that you get from your family members. I'd like the family of these athletes to please stand up.
Last quarter's honor roll, so this team is not just first class on the field.
field. It's also first class in the classroom. And much like
Thank you.
stage has been set that you have a tremendous challenge ahead of you. I know I've been in schools where we've been very successful before, and it seems like when you're successful, everybody expects you to continue, which means starting tomorrow with the other sports, the weight room will always be open, and the summer camps and all. You know now what it takes to be a champion. It takes a lot of hard work and a lot of dedication. And I personally would like to issue a challenge to next year's Marceline Tigers squad to see if you can maybe go back to Columbia or Busch Stadium, wherever it's at. It's going to be something that would have to be even greater because you would be 2A next year. But that should not make any difference. Really, it would not matter what class you're in, the same way it does not matter how big you are. It takes a lot of heart, it takes a lot up here, and that desire will win in the end. That's what it takes. Last but not least, I would like to thank my coaching staff, Kurt Llewellyn, Rich Mobley, and Galen Hicks, for their assistance this year. I'm sure it's been rough on them too with the hour spent. We were talking last night about some of the things on the sideline, about how involved some of the members of the coaching staff will get. I guess it's me. And I didn't realize I chew on them too. But they're very nice. They will not say anything about it. I guess now that it's over, they're telling me that sometimes I do. But I'm sure these guys will have an enjoyable offseason, and they're glad they don't have me to chew on anymore the rest of the season. Again, I'd like to thank you all for the support. It was tremendous when we walked out on that field and look up in the north end of the stadium and see all the black and gold and the cheers. It just seemed like, you know, it was going to happen. With that type of support, it would happen. The last thing I would like to do is I would like to present the state championship trophy to the school. Captains, would you like to come up and assist me?
Goals were set to win the conference, but Bell game and make it into the state playoffs. The fruits of those efforts are there on that table. These guys sitting here, I like to call it quiet determination. There wasn't a lot of hoopla in the halls. They just seemed to know what they needed to do, and then they just went out and took care of it. They were asked to give their best in each game, and they did that. They gave their best, and now they are the best.
Just to be good. We want to be the best, and we are. Thank you all.